Well, hello there, everyone. You have right here, you're talking about, for the Disney Movie Club, and you have right here of have right here is these I say have right here is the Mickey Mouse right here. But yeah, that in case of anybody that may warrant where that if there's going to be any source of a portable television set or anything about the based on remote control, and you might say that yeah, they're going to have a button with everything else. Except the fact about if you're gonna maybe have movie if you're gonna be a member through the an account through the movie club then you one or two that how come that they don't have all this other than that nice and fancy stuff such as remote controls or maybe cameras to where you can actually look at your favorite Disney character for like a little nightlight and in case of anybody that say that yeah nightlights that about how old do you really had to be just to grow out of those night lights. But you have right here but with Mickey Mouse right here, and you have right here is for Minnie Mouse. So it's like, yeah. We all remember playing those Sega Genesis games. I'm like, the games back in those days, back in the early 80s and 90s, to where that you would be able to play those games with the favorite Disney characters right here. But talk about with the movie club though, and this right and then I I use this right here just to show them like yeah that you're able to some of these Disney characters that you're able to purchase these make purchases through the at the store right here but talk about the movies that you get into the movie club and have right here is Pinocchio right here and you have this coupon this it's already been used but you would have these coupons right here whenever you would get a new movie on Blu-ray, from the movie club, but then you would enter this in to the website, and then you'll be able to earn points that way and all that. And but in case of if we're likely weren't to about having an account that really that would a child really mention about they're gonna bring something in for show and tell, and that goes that they're gonna go maybe mention about a movie that. That they're gonna that they found maybe around the parents' house, and let's just say that if there's a if daddy or if there's gonna be a, maybe a brother, an older brother that's gonna maybe have an account through the Disney Movie Club, that's I say if it's in movies anywhere or if it's gonna be through the movie club, and then you're gonna find a Disney movie that one of your favorite Disney movies or maybe something that you haven't seen, but you have right here's Pinocchio right here. And you see right here is the front cover, front and back cover right there for Pinocchio. But I could say, tell anybody here that, some of these movies, they can get expensive. And I know that for most of the time, though, that with a lot of these movies that on Blu-ray, that the reasons to maybe why that, you feel a couple times about maybe you're canceling the membership because about, maybe if they're, like once a month that you're going to be charged, a couple bucks, something like that, about maybe up to 5 or maybe up to 10%, 10, 11% or something like that, maybe up to 20%, for a movie, like once a month that you'll get a movie and then, you'll be able to, as soon as you get the movie, then you'll be able to enter the coupon code that, for the online, just to be able to, earn enough points to get free movies and anything else that the movie club has to offer. And the way I think about it too, that in case of anybody that may ask me that, movies like Alice in Wonderland, I'm thinking about movies that a lot of times whenever you're going up to those stores and then you can't find them on the shelves or that they're maybe sold out. I've been there a couple of times to where if I'm going to be, going up to the store, between, the hours and 7 to 8 o'clock or so in the morning, whenever there's a movie that's going to be released, on Blu-ray and maybe on the combo pack, and then I'm going to go up to a store like maybe Walmart or somewhere like that, BestBuy.com, I'm going to go up to the Best Buy store or somewhere like that to go get a movie. And, sometimes it's like, yeah, if the movies are sold out and sometimes that's what happens. And like, say you'll have, it was the Avengers, but I have right here is Star Wars. And I know, like movies like Star Wars and then it's also the Black Panther, and sometimes that, movies that, you know, like the Black Panther right here, that, you know, sometimes if you don't even order those movies, sometimes that they are automatically through the movie club account, and then those movies are delivered to you. And which I think it's pretty convenient, because I know if you can't always go to the store, if you get busy with whatever it's going on at home or maybe at work or something like that, then you can't always go by the store to get the movies. And in case somebody would say, yeah, they ought to maybe do that maybe for the coffee, have the coffee automatically delivered or something. But, any coffee makers or maybe, anything about that, if you're going to have like a coffee maker or a tea maker or something like that, any sort of maker at home, and want to know about anything that you can do by mobile, that you can have, if you drink a lot of coffee and then have that coffee made, from a coffee maker. And if you ever wondered where, if you're going to be running out of mix, and want to know about if you can order that coffee, even by mobile online. But you have right here of talking about to the Disney Movie Club right here. And movies like this right here, Alice in Wonderland, those sorts of movies right here, then I have been there to where that you go up to the store and try to look for movies like this. And sometimes either that they're sold out or if they don't have them in stock, because I know that, like, we might think too that, Best Buy would usually have a lot of these movies, but then if you ordered them online, they would have, a lot of times they would have the movies. But there's been a couple times I go into Best Buy and sometimes they don't have the movies. And like Walmart too. I'm like, you go into these certain retail stores, and some of these stores that don't have the movie, any particular movie that you're looking for. And just like the music stores. I'm like, yeah, any CDs or any soundtracks or some sort that if you're going to be going to a music store just to be able to find, by a particular artist or by if it was maybe the 80s classic soundtracks or any sorts of music like that. But talk about, through the movie club here, I guess, the best part about this is to word it, with movies, your favorite movies, on Blu-ray, that, let's just say that, about if we do the calculations, if you were calculating to word about how much money that you were paying for satellite TV compared to like the movie club, because movies that you get mailed to you from the movie club, they're about maybe $30 or $40, but then live streaming too, you have access to be able to have access to live streaming and all that through the movie club, and compared to what you could be paying you through the cable packages. But and I know, in case of if we want one or two, that's really all our choice, ain't it? Whenever we're going to be wanting to watch a movie, that shouldn't this all what we do, what we see in these commercials, shouldn't that be about how we want to watch the movie whenever we like? Back in the old days, whenever you had to rent a movie, then you would only have about maybe 4 or 5 days or so to watch it before it's due back. But before you had to return it. But still, that movies like Alice in Wonderland, that go into the store and then you'll be looking for it in the store, and then there's going to maybe by a couple of times that go up to about maybe 3 or 4 different locations just to find the movie, and then they'll tell you if they got it, in stock. But Jurassic World was the name of that I went up there, in Walmart. It was probably about, I think it was about, 7-8 o'clock in the morning. I went up there to see if they had the movie, and but other than that, it was the Avengers movie that I remember going to about 3 other locations just to see if they had the movie. And then, Transformers also. And I know that other movies that we probably say that, movies that you might find on Netflix later on too, and, on Hulu.com. But still though, that with these movies here, I have this, in case of anybody that may say that movies that if you always really have time really to watch these movies and thinking as to word it, for any reason at all, that you go up to the, go to the stores And sometimes that, you know, you're talking about more than $20 and sometimes up to $30 it is for a movie. And you're likely thinking too that, you know, in case of anybody that want to bother you about, you know, exactly, why do you buy them if you don't watch them? But really, that if you're going to have any visitor, I'm like, yeah, grandkids, if you're going to have any kids, maybe cousins' kids, or I'm like, yeah, if you're going to have any kids over, if you're going to be babysitting maybe one Saturday morning or something like that, something, you know, if you're going to have company one of these days, then they're going to maybe see something like Alice in Wonderland in your movie collection. They're going to maybe see something like, yeah, Star Wars. And and yeah, that, you know, if you're going to be babysitting, and then maybe that there's going to be times to where that there's going to be a movie that's, you know, for rated PG-13. So if there's going to be anybody that's going to be babysitting and likely weren't to where that, can we watch this? Like, an, oh, it's PG-13. It's okay, if it's okay with mommy, you know, to watch it, mommy or daddy or, you know, uncle or, you know, yeah, if it's okay with aunt. But, you know, still, though, that, you know, any movies, I'm like, yeah, any movies that maybe kids would probably like to ask if they would like to watch. And the first thing that you're going to maybe mention is to word, yeah, for PG-13. So I know that, you know, not all movies that, that you get to your Disney Movie Club membership, that it's like I say, you know, for it, that if it's going to be for PG-13. But really, though, that nowadays with the movies, with these accounts nowadays, it seems like, you know, for parental control set, you know, in case they, if you're going to be on the Xbox One game console, you know, can you really control about what your children are watching? If it's PG-13 or if it's rated R, and you're likely weren't too. If something comes on TV, then, you know, as long as the kids are behaving, they can go ahead and watch it. But still, though, that if we're talking about, you know, anything related to, you know, yeah, that, you know, any movies, any Disney movies that would be considered violent. And if I say, yeah, besides Star Wars, so that it could maybe be, you know, like Jurassic Park. And I know there's a lot of kids. There might be a lot of kids out there who are big fans of dinosaurs, and if it's the good dinosaur, they could probably say that, you know, trying to make sure that, you know, if there's going to be a movie that's going to be coming up on TV, especially if you're going to be having an account, you're going to have, you know, younger kids that are going to be on the game consoles, and there's going to be a movie, you know, such as, you know, the Jurassic World they're going to want to watch. And I say that, yeah, you know, any movies. But still, though, that we were too. Movies that are going to be coming out in the near future, are they going to even have ratings on there? And if they are, then I want to know about, you know, exactly about, you know, have younger kids. You know, if there's going to be a rating such as what you call, you know, family you can handle or something. I'm not trying to make a tea, but yeah, family you can handle, to where that any movies that any movies that if you're going to be watching it as a family or something like that, you know, it's like, say, well, you know, it's like, say, yeah, movies like PG-13 or PG or maybe just G, and you're likely warned too that you know, any movies that you're going to have around, and you know, or you're going to be streaming live and want to know about, you know, about they need you to prove your age. But really, that so far, the Disney Movie Club has not asked me for any source of ID. So in case of anybody that may want to work, now, how do you control it? I know it. You know, so far as gifts-wise, that with a lot of these Disney movies that you do order, or if you're, you know, if they are on what you call on your account. So in case of anybody that may ask, is that with this movie club right here, they come, you know, if you don't always have the time to go out and do the shopping, then you can, like I say, that, you know, yeah, I'll go ahead and just, you know, yeah, you know, around the 4th of July holiday, if there's a movie that you want to go ahead and get there at the store, and let's just say that if it's going to maybe be, maybe, you know, a movie such as Star Wars, or it could also be about that, you know, movies about the great freedom for America, or something like that. And I don't know, there might be a couple of movies, maybe not Disney movies, but there might be some movies out there that have something really too about, the birth of America, the freedom for America or something like that. And then, somebody's, a kid's going, family members are going to probably want to watch that movie. And you're likely one or two having an account through like Microsoft, or if it's going to maybe be like, eBay or Amazon, or if it's going to be through the movie club, then, we would be able to have access to an account and be able to make purchases to, through the Google Play Store. Yeah. Through Google Play, be able to rent some of these movies. And, I guess at the whole, plan, I guess, is to make it more convenient for these customers, because I know there's probably been we may have all experienced that, to where we go to the store, we're not able to find a movie that we're looking for. And so in order to be relevant to these customers, if you're going in there just to look for our latest release of a movie of a certain title, then you're likely to say that, we don't really like that whenever we see something that's going to be out of stock. And then in order to be able to make sure it's in stock, and then notice I say, you can order it online. And so I know one movie that I know was the Avengers, but Star Wars, though. And I know that the last time, like, I think, I don't know if this was episode 7, but... in case of anybody that may ask me that movies that I have around, but still though, that I know that movies that have not even been opened here, if we can see this right here, movies that have not even been opened. And in case of anybody that may ask me that, what is it? Are you supposed to, make it look like the original? I'm like, yeah, what that makes it make the movie more attractive. It's never been opened before, so you're just going to have this on, maybe on your display, shelf, here at home, and want to know about, is there any reason at all to, or why you still have it unwrapped out of the package? Is it supposed to be a Christmas present or what? But in case of anybody that may ask me that, if there's going to be any movies that have never been opened, and you're likely warned too, that, you never bothered to open it. I'm like, yeah. In case that there's anybody that may want to, where you're going to maybe have little kids, they're going to want to say, if I want to watch it, I can go ahead and bite down. I'm like, any reason at all to where it's not so hard to open up a movie, to open up a movie just to watch it. But still, though, that with movies that have never been opened, and I know that whenever I think about this also, that, a lot of these movies right here, that whenever I look at these, and like we say that, do they look better whenever they're all wrapped up still in the package? But still though, that with a lot of these movies right here, that you're likely thinking too, that that whenever I look at these movies, then sometimes always have time really to open them out of the package, and then somebody's going to ask the question. But still, though, that if I were to be ordering these movies to, like, BestBuy.com or somewhere like that, some movie club like that, and but still, on average, it's between $20 and $30 a month, for some of these movies. And how many of us will maybe agree that maybe if that is a little bit too much money than compared to renting them on through the Google Play Store? But still, though, that, in case they say that, just like Green Eggs and Ham, would you watch the movie if you had a partner with you or something like that? Stuffed animal or anything else that the Disney movie had to offer. I'm like, yeah, comfortable blankets. We wonder too that, Disney movies, a lot of times on for a movie night, if you're going to be watching Pinocchio, how come the movie club that don't offer to send you something maybe a blanket or two, maybe to sit down and relax one Saturday night to watch a movie with somebody that you know of. You're going to invite them over, maybe for some popcorn or something like that, or, maybe for a sandwich night or something, you're going to pop in a movie. And so you're likely thinking, it's true, they offer almost everything else. Or then, sandwich night or something like that. But still, that in case of anybody that may ask, is that if you're going to have any company or like any source of future date, that you're likely one or two that You know, I was like, yeah, any movies that you might have around the house or anywhere that, you know, like they say, you'll want to watch a movie. And then I think as to where it, you know, yeah, the best event about having a movie account. And, you know, and I know that, you know, if you, I talked to a few people that, you know, I say that, yeah, especially on Facebook, that you talk to anybody on there and they're going to want to know about how does this, how does that movie account work? And you're using a lot of a digital technology also for digital movies. And I can tell anybody here with my degree in, you know, for digital design that I know quite a bit about how it works about having an account. And yeah, that for digital movies, you know, anywhere. And I know that anything as such as what you call movies, though. And but still, though, in case of anybody that may ask me that, why is it that I never really, you say, you know, if you would really have to cancel the membership unless you had to. But still, though, that, you know, I know how hard it is going to the store just to look for a certain movie. And sometimes that they're going to be sold out of them. And then you're likely thinking, too, that, that if they're sold out, you know, maybe have to go somewhere else or if anything, order them online. So I know that a lot of these movies here that, you know, I want to mention this, too, about Alice in Wonderland, because I know that, you know, usually like places like Walmart would usually have movies like this right here on Blu-ray. But still, though, that, you know, once or twice you go there and, you know, if it's not there and then you say you know, order it online. But still, though, that I know with me, since I stay busy on, you know, class and with work also, and you're likely thinking, too, that, you know, maybe not everybody has, you know, the time to spend, you know, 15, 20 minutes, you know, or maybe even a half an hour, you know, looking for a certain artist, a certain soundtrack, or maybe a certain video game of some sort. So they're going to say they have a Disney Movie Club that helps out because you know, be able to have a, be able to, you know, through the membership, you know, it's like as long as your account is active and then that you would have the movies delivered to you. And so that's just a thing that with the movie club. And so, yeah, movies I had not seen in a very long time that, you know, you're able to find them pretty simply through the movie club. So in case if anybody would ask me that about movies, though, that do you have more than one copy of this? I can, no, I don't. You know, it's movies that I have bought from before on VHS that that I don't have, like, say, yeah. So any movies that you're going to be getting, and you're likely thinking, too, that having an account through the movie club. The first thing I can say is that, that yeah, that back whenever I was about 11, 12 years old, of course, you say, yeah, before you even had your own computer, but you say, yeah, you can do that from your phone, too. You can order movies from your phone. So in case if anybody say, yeah, anything about shopping experience, you know, anything about shopping experience, you know, what excuse is there to why that maybe you don't have a copy of this yet? But, you know, still that with Disney movies, though, that that I know that, you know, having a having an account through the movie club, that the first thing I can say is to where that, you know, you might have been too young to have your own account, but then maybe you'll be young enough to where you could be able to watch, you know, some of these movies. And so it's like, yeah, I'm going to have a favorite Disney movie like The Three Musketeers. I'm like, you know, so yeah, other movies that I don't have here yet, but still that, you know, having a movie, you know, having an account through the movie club. And I know that, you know, Mickey Mouse was, you know, for my first birthday, you know, my very first birthday that I can remember that was on my birthday cake. So in case of anybody say that, you know, yeah, that is it possible one of these days that I'm going to be getting an email from the movie club and saying, you know, hey, happy birthday. You know, you earned an extra 100 points or something like that, you know, to pick out whatever Disney movie that that you want. But and I know that, and I don't know if anybody knows about those Dairy Queen commercials either. Yeah, Dairy Queen commercials. You know, a lot of those people, you know, anybody who goes up to Dairy Queen to go get an ice cream, especially if it's going to be, you know, a smoothie or an ice cream cone, or maybe, you know, the, or if it's maybe the special design cakes, but you're going to maybe have a tour of the Dairy Queen commercials as to what can you do online with the Dairy Queen, you know, the Dairy Queen advertisements. So there's, if you want to go in there, maybe for the brownie earthquake or like, you know, anything, you know, for the hot fudge sundaes or for the ice cream cones, you know, anything the Dairy Queen has to offer. And you're like thinking too that if you're going to have an account through the Dairy Queen, through Dairy Queen, and then you're likely thinking too that likely warrant to where that these special offers that go on at between 8, maybe 10 or 11 o'clock in the morning or so, the happy hour sale or something like that, through Dairy Queen. But anyway, through the movie club right here, that that I know that, movies like Star Wars, and then there was also, the Avengers also, but still, that I know, through with Star Wars, though, I'm talking about three movies that that I know that I had were delivered to me through the movie club, and like the Black Panther right here, and you didn't order them, they're still gonna be what you call people say that if you don't have time to order it also, then you can always try to say if you're gonna have an account through the movie club, then they might just automatically send you just like as long as you're paying. As long as your account is all updated with, from the best offers, and then it's fine. Those orders are going to be placed automatically. And in case of anybody like one or two that that if it makes it more convenient for anybody that if it's through the movies, but still, same thing maybe with the concert tickets or maybe the hotel, your motel stays or anywhere like that, anywhere that you're going to be going on vacation. That you were too. That stuff that you can do online as well. But still, though, that with the movie club, that's basically about what I would have to say about it, is to where that back whenever I was young, that there was a Disney movie that I want to have. You see the commercial advertisements, and a lot of times it says, "Do I get it before it's gone or something like that, or get it before it expires?" But in case if anybody were asked me that, why is it that points, whenever you redeem points through the Disney movies club, but that how come most of them are only good for 90 days? So in case if we're likely weren't to word it, you earn points through the movie club, and sometimes if you can't use all those points, but still though that I know that with those points though, that 90 days usually. Those coupons are usually good for 90 days. So in case if anybody were asked me that, why is it? Because it's like, 90 days sometimes it don't last long either. So that's about 3 months, something like that, that those coupon codes are going to be expiring. And I want to know about why is it that they expire within a certain time. But I guess there might be a number of reasons to why that these coupons are going to expire. But one of those reasons could also be about as to where if this next time that, if you do shop, and then let's just say if you do buy something that's going to maybe be worth even more points. So I can say that, with a lot of these points that, it's not really about the fact about that if you're going to be running out of the points, but then that, you can renew the points. So I can think too that, whenever you do have points, if you want to call maybe credits too, if you're going to have credits to the movie club, and when it's like pick out whichever movie that you like to order, and so it's like so it seems like it happens a lot of time. If you're trying to show somebody how this works, and then if you got credits in your account, if you have points in the account, then you can show them, walk them through about what this is how this works. Whenever you buy a movie, and then let's just say if somebody were says that, I bought this movie right here. Now, I'll go and use Pinocchio since Pinocchio has already been opened, everybody. But, still, that with Pinocchio right here, that you see right here is Pinocchio right here. And they bought this movie, but then they don't know how this works right here. They don't know how this part works right here to go to their website and then enter this code right here. So let's just say that, somebody were to say that, they bought this at the local store, but then they don't know how to do this online. So they're going to maybe ask me about how this works, and then I can show them about this is how this works. Go to this website here. And it's like saying, you open up a package, and in those movies, the DVD and then digital HD copy are in there. But, like I say, it's to where that, I would like to know a little bit about how this works, about how to, redeem, just for awards. And it says on here to get rewarded with the Disney, for the movie awards. If it's through apparel, and then there's also the movie admissions, and then the Blu-ray and DVDs, and then the Disney experience. So like at the theme park. So yeah. Yeah, I don't know if anybody has been there to where that if they earn enough points to where that they're able to win free tickets to the theme park, to the Disney World. But still, that I know most of those families who've been wanting to go to Disney World or Disneyland for quite a long time, that you really had the time and believe that that you can maybe earn a free vacation somewhere just by buying. Buying about maybe 7 movies, and then you earn enough points to do that. But still though, that I would say that is it really worth the try? I'm like, yeah, but I know that maybe not everybody has the time to do a lot of stuff, and maybe if whenever plans change. But still though, the opportunity to learn about how online accounts work, because I know that we might be thinking too is to where that a lot of the movies that were, especially around the holidays, if you're going to be shopping around for those movies and you can't find them,